Hello, welcome back to another video, and this one is going to be about my Notion setup. And I know I briefly went over it in my previous video, but today I wanted to just take you guys throughout like a walkthrough of everything and also show you guys how to do some of the basic things in Notion. And so I'll also show you guys in my own setup and how I basically changed and simplified my own template for my personal setup. And so without further ado, let's just get right into it. And this is the first page you will log on to when you go on to Notion. And for me, I just like it simple. I made a to-do list that you can basically change every day. It's just like quick at a glance to-do list. It might not even have to be your detailed work stuff. So I put things like get groceries. And if you see the little triangle, that's a toggle list. And so you can click the triangle and you can make like more lists. I like it because you can just hide it when you want to. And another function that I really like are the checkboxes, the to-do list, just because I just like seeing a box and I like checking it off when I'm done a certain work. So that's something that's also really good. And then another one is just bullet points. And then if we move down to the academic section, this is for all the students that are taking courses, and especially online courses, the files and documents and everything can get so hectic. So my first document is the grades and assignment. So maybe I'll just do a quick run through of the grades and assignments documents, but basically this one you can change it to anything you want. So maybe it's like attendance, and then you can add a due date. And then the good thing about this is that if you add all the due dates and everything, you can actually add a view and you can look at it as a timeline. So I just created the timeline, and if you scroll through, you can actually see when your assignments are due. You can also add like different studying periods, but for me, I just like to keep it on the default view because I just like to see everything at a glance, and especially the grade calculator, because I don't know about you, but some of my courses, they don't tell you the final grades until like the end, which is kind of annoying. So I just have to kind of guess my way throughout my course. And now moving on to the calendar, this is where you can enter your study plan, and it doesn't just have a monthly view. You can also go in and look at it as a timeline. And so I wrote like start working on assignments, and you can drag it across and see when your other things are due as well. And then you can also do, let's say, like list view at all your different assignments and your studying goals. And then table view, and that's just, again, table that's like shows you everything you want. And so let's change the colors to make it a little prettier because we want to make our Notion aesthetic. But this way you can really easily track what's due for your courses, and you can do like 4 different colors, 5 depending on what your course load is. And for me, I just like keeping the assignment due dates as red because that just like screams at me, and that way I know when it's like due. I actually don't take my study notes on Notion just because I don't want it to be too cluttered. So I'll just link the Google Doc, and you can link your Zoom links, you can link other like course material, and that way it doesn't have to all show up on Notion. Now moving on to the career section, I kept it pretty simple just because I wanted a very straightforward to-do list. But one of you guys commented on my TikTok and asked for something that would just like help people that are looking for different jobs. And so I found this template on Notion, and it's their job application tracker. And I think this would be really good for people if you're applying to a bunch of different jobs and you want to have your like resume, your cover letters, and everything like in one place. This will be really good for you. And so I didn't change it that much. I just kept the Notion template. To add a new template, you just go into your section on the left, the little bar that like comes out, and at the bottom it will say template. And then you click that. The ones that I personally use the most are in the personal section, and there's a lot that you can just check out. I think marketing is also really good if you want to do a content calendar, if you want to do a mood board. And yeah, so this is kind of where you can get some inspiration also, and to look at different templates. All right, so I have a lot of pages, so we're just gonna move right on. This next one is the budget and finance. And this one I've basically set up so that you can track your monthly spendings. And there's different sections where you can write out a list of things you're saving for, your major purchases this year, and then like also gift ideas, so you can keep track of how much you want to spend and what you want to get people. Because I know throughout the year, sometimes my friends will just talk about the things that they want. And so this is a good place to just write that down. And so you can always come back for their birthday or for Christmas and check their list of the things that they want. This is very much how I want to organize my life, and so I just hope that it works for you guys as well. And I would have to say that my favorite part of this budget and finance page is the bubble tea tracker, because I don't know, it's so cute. And I just think it's time that I should track my bubble tea consumption, because how am I gonna cut down on it if I don't even know how much I drink? Like, sometimes without even realizing it, I'm drinking it every week, which is crazy. But now, because of COVID and not quarantine, but we're just staying at home, I haven't been going out and buying bubble tea, so I'm actually saving quite a bit of money. And then if you scroll down, I just have a little budgeting template, and this is also copied from Notion, because they do have really good like tables, I find, like charts and stuff that you can use, and they do all the calculations for you, which is why I took it. I feel like I'm talking too much already, but this is my weekly spread. I basically took my inspiration from a lot of bullet journaling. I've looked at like different bullet journal like layouts and just find the ones that work best for me, and this is the system that I like. On the weekend, I try to give myself the most rest I can, and so I cram everything else during the weekday, which is why I also crammed the weekend together, so hopefully there isn't much in this to-do list. And then moving down, I have the miscellaneous pages, which is where I just want to keep a little section that can link me to all my other pages. I know other people have done this with charts and just like page links, but I like the way that this looks, and I like how you can see the covers for everything. When you click into everything, it just creates a new page for you, and you can open as a page to make it bigger. And then you can just add different things. You can also rearrange all these sections if you want, and depending on like what's more important to you. The questions that I've been getting a lot is how to create this. So if you hit slash and you move down to gallery inline, and that's how you create like a new one. The way that I have moved like bigger items into different sections is if I create the sections first. So if you see, I'm dragging it over to here, let go. And then another tip is to add colors, because that's like way easier to look at, and you can just see when the section like starts and ends. But you add the color, and then you can actually just drag this whole thing right underneath, so you see how the line is only half, let go, and so that way it makes it really small. And then you can also just like make it smaller. Now I'm gonna show you guys my personal page. This is a little bit different than my template, just because I made it simpler, as I have said before, but it's just because that I personally don't need a weekly spread. I will just come onto this every day and refresh my to-do list. And so I deleted the weekly stuff and I just added a to-do list, one that's for life and one that's for work. I also changed my covers a little bit to fit a more mature and like color aesthetic theme. And I want to show you guys my 2021 memories page that I've completely changed. I've added a different cover for every month, and this just like looking at it just makes me motivated to journal more. And this is for my monthly reflections, but it's basically just like a month at a glance kind of thing, and so I can look back afterwards and see how my month goes, because I have really bad memory. So hopefully the walkthrough helped you guys. I know it's not like super in detail, but that's because I also want to show you guys how to just create your own little templates or your own sections. But now I'm gonna bring you guys up into a new document, and I'll show you guys some of the basics with Notion and just how you guys can really customize everything. When I first started, I went to look at the templates first, and this is where I found all the templates that you can use. And so I think a lot of people use the personal home one. A lot of people start here. And so you can just click use this template and it'll load and everything. So first thing I do is just to change the covers, change it to something that like inspires you or sets like the theme for the page. So another thing that I like to do is go into the settings, and that's just the top right corner when you see the three dots. And then I like to click full width, and that basically changes so you can use the entire page. And then you can also adjust the text and make it smaller, and then you can change the fonts. I know this font is also very popular. Honestly, all three fonts are really good, and they're just different like aesthetics. And then now we can go into how to move things around and just the basic. So like I mentioned, you grab the six dots, and that's how you can basically drag things around, and you just look for all those lines. Another tip is to just highlight it, and you can actually see the sections that it's breaking like up into. And like, if you want to add something here, as you can see, if you add something, I'll just add a color. It actually crops off where the border is. And so if you wanted to make a new section under this, I usually just like drag something down until I see a full line. And so that just means that your next section should be a full line, as you can see. And if you want to move it back in, just move it back and then see the shortened bar and you just drop it and it will go back into the two sections. All right, and now I'll go over the different commands that you can use. So as you can see, it already shows up as type slash for command. So we're gonna type slash, and there's text, there's pages, all these things that you can explore. I definitely like using the different databases. Those are ways that you can make different charts, calendars, boards, and such. And also adding images. So when you look at my template, you might have seen my calendar. I actually made it on Canvas, and so you just go into Canvas and you search calendar, and they have a bunch of different templates that like you can use, and basically just choose the one that like fits your aesthetic, and then you can always just download this image and then crop it with your phone or your computer and move that image into Notion. And you can also do this for like inspirational quotes or different like words you want to have, or maybe even images you want to have in your Notion, just so that you can decorate it even more. And some people have embedded audio files, and so I think you have to either download it and upload a file or embed the link for that. So if I go into my Spotify and I can just like copy the playlist link, and then you just paste it into here, and just make sure to click create embed, because that will actually make the little widget that we see. And so yeah, that's how you add that. And if you want to move this around, just also drag it, look for the line, and then it should just pop up right there. I hope this video helped you guys. I know I didn't go into detail on like every single thing. I think I actually did a better job in my previous video going over the basics, just because I was a beginner myself, and so I still had a lot of like questions that I wanted to answer and to show you guys. And so in this one, I might have like skipped over the very basics. But anyways, if you haven't checked out my other one, feel free to do so. I'll just link it in here or like up here. But yeah, I actually filmed this right before a work meeting, so I have to go now, but I'll see you guys in the next one. And if you guys have any questions or comments, just leave them down below, or you can also DM me on Instagram and I'll answer all your Notion questions. Thank you. Bye. I wanna know your name. Baby, you're bubbly and radiant. You got some flavor and I'm trying to save